All right, our next guest just arrived at the studio. It's Eco Moliterno. He's Chief Creative Officer of Accenture Interactive in Latin America. Yeah. You just flew in last night, you just told me.
Yep. But it's straight from Brazil, long way.
Long way. It's warmer there right now. It's not bad here, but...
Yeah, it's basically the same. At this time of the year, the whole planet has almost the same temperature. Okay. So it's not that different.
So it's kind of home.
Yeah.
Temperature-wise. You've been here last year. You just shared with me. On the first day, could you see some differences, something changed, something positive maybe, or...
Yeah, the first time I came here to the Mexico, I was really impressed about the size of the event.
Yeah.
Because it's not a very well-known event in Latin America. So when I got here, I said, oh my God, how big is that? And I think this year is even bigger.
Okay.
So it's growing even more. So, so it's really good to be here and to see all the big players here at the same space.
They're basically all here.
Yeah, everyone, yeah.
So you're also working for a very big player, Accenture Interactive. But looking back to where you started, where did your path begin? What did you do first?
Well, that's a long story.
Are you prepared? I have time. No problem.
I started when I was 16 years old as a cartoonist, doing caricatures and cartoons for magazines. My first job was on a rock magazine.
Oh.
I used to draw the rock stars, Axl Rose, the guys from the 90s
when
I started. Then I moved to Denmark. I did high school in Denmark. I finished my high school in Denmark on an exchange program. And it was 1995, the year that internet popped out.
Yeah.
It was a closed system, then it became a commercial system.
Right.
And I started studying internet in Denmark because we had internet at school. So when I first got there, I thought it was something only for Denmark. Then I realized it was the whole planet. So when I came back to Brazil, I decided I want to work with that. I still keep doing my cartoons. I draw for the biggest magazine in Latin America every month.
Awesome.
It's still a side job. But then I started working with internet. And so I went to the University of Advertising. Then I started doing advertising for the internet. And I started working my first job in advertising was at the first digital agency in Brazil called Agência Click.
Okay.
Many years ago, at the past century, past millennium, right? 1999.
Millennium. Not so many people can say that, right?
Yeah, but I can. And so since then, I started working at Agência Click. Then I moved to AOL Brazil to establish a creative department inside there. Then I moved to Wonderman. That when I was starting, it's a digital operation in the world, so I started it in Brazil. Then I moved to another agency called Africa. It's not an African agency, it's a Brazilian agency, one of the biggest ones. I was there for 7 years, the past 7 years. And then 1.5 years ago, I moved to Accenture. Actually, I went out of the advertising industry to start something new. I've always started something new since the beginning.
Yeah.
And I feel like I'm restarting again at this amazing company.
So on the first view, you would not bring, you know, you combine Accenture with creation and with your job and, you know, all kind of creative works. So explain us a little, what does a normal day look like? So what is your daily work for the company?
The difference between what I do now and what I used to do at the advertising agencies is the kind of creative work I do. When you're on an advertising agency, you work at the end of the process.
Right.
So they develop a service or a product, they scale it, they prepare everything. When it's ready to go to the market,
they
call the
call
agencies
to
announce it. Inside Accenture Interactive, I operate since the beginning.
Okay.
So I have the chance to use my creative work to influence things when the product is not ready yet.
Okay.
And for me, it's amazing
because...
It happened a lot of times with me, but we had to announce something. But it said, what if the name was, no, we can change now.
Sure.
It's already launched and everything set up. Well, a pity, because it would be better if the name was like this, or the color was like this, or the shape was like this. And now I feel like I can influence since the beginning. So for me, it's like being on paradise, because I'm learning a lot. I think that's the best part. And I'm helping them to establish a creative process throughout the whole process. The whole line.
And since Accenture is a global operating company, Is there a certain type of creative work or of design language in Latin America or in Brazil compared to Europe and Denmark? And
good question. I think Brazilians, they are creative by nature. I say that in Brazil, you have to be creative to survive, mm-hmm. because everything, you don't have a support from the government. Everything, it's not ready yet, Brazil. Yeah. So we have to improvise all the time. That makes us creative by nature. So I think the idea has a tremendous power in Brazil. I think here in Europe, for example, execution is side by side with idea. In Latin America, by far, idea is the top thing.
Okay.
So I think being part of a structure like Accenture is teaching me how to combine creativity with brilliant execution. In terms of developing new services, developing new product, it's not about executing the creative work.
Yeah.
It's executing the product itself. And what we do most is digital transformation of our clients and involves everything. Services, products, the structure of the client itself. So for me, it's like having the chance to use the Latin America creative power mm-hmm. to influence the European execution.
Okay.
So it's the perfect mix.
When you wake up in the morning, what is the first thing you do?
Wow, I take a shower. Because I think it's the moment where all my best ideas come from. Because I don't know if I was just sleeping and I had dreams and then I wash everything away and the idea remains.
Okay.
So I think every time I go to the shower in the morning, an idea comes up.
That's interesting.
It influences my whole day. So for me, it's like it's a rule. I have to take a shower in the morning.
Okay. So and after that, I assume you switch on your phone at some point. And what do you do then?
Instagram and
favorite
Facebook,
apps,
emails. Instagram, I think it's one of my favorite apps. And I'm addicted to Waze as well because we have a lot of traffic jam in São Paulo where I'm based. So it's
okay.
Crucial to have Waze. So since I wake up, I start looking at my mobile phone. And I think that's another thing to be another good thing to be inside Accenture, because we are working on the consumer experience. So it's not about anymore only announcing something.
Yeah.
It's really creating a new experience for the consumers. And the apps are all about that. After they are established, they started doing advertising
right.
and creating a brand. But first they focus on the experience.
Right.
And that's something that I'm learning now in Accenture.
Do you have a bucket list? And what would be like on top one or two?
I have a long bucket list in terms of going to places and knowing things. I think one of the top ones, I want to become a father. I think hopefully it will happen soon.
Mm-hmm.
And I want to position myself to have more time with my kids
okay.
as a creative consultant. So I think there is a lot of room, a lot of space for creative people outside the advertising world, outside the agencies, the advertising agencies. It's something that I realized when I moved to Accenture, because a lot of other areas need our work.
Creativity in your work.
So my top personal bucket list would be become a father, and my personal professional one, become a creative consultant to the clients.
Two nice ones. How do you learn new things? Do you have a special way or type of media? Is it visual? Is it audio, podcasting? Is it books?
I think all of them. When we work with the creative, we have a kind of creative work, you have to be inspired all the time. I say that there are three things that must inspire us. Morning, afternoon, and evening. Mm-hmm. So all the time you have to be connected and looking what people are doing, what people are saying, because suddenly comes up an idea that solves a problem, a client of one of your clients. So you have to be connected all the time. So if you're watching TV, if you're listening to the radio, so I try to be a blank page all mm-hmm. the time mm-hmm. to filled up by other people around me. Everyone around us knows and does something better than us. I think that's a premise for all my life. That's a mantra. Mm-hmm. Everyone, you do mm-hmm. something better mm-hmm. than me. Everyone. So there's always an opportunity to learn with other people something new. I think that's my rule.
Who would you love to meet on a one-on-one lunch tomorrow for an hour if I could arrange it?
Anyone.
Anyone.
Dead or alive.
Your choice.
I would love to meet Al Hirschfeld. He was, I think, the most famous cartoonist, caricaturist in the planet. I went to his house in 1999 in New York, and I gave my portfolio to him, and he wrote a letter to me, and I never had the chance to say thank you because he died some years ago.
Oh.
So I'd love to meet him again and say, thank you, you gave me the most precious thing I have. It's a letter from you saying that you love my drawings, my portfolio. So,
okay.
But I didn't have the chance.
Okay. And how do you recharge? Because creativity always sucks up a lot of energy. Like you said, you're a blank page, and then morning, noon, and at the evening, you have these three stops during the day, sucking everything up. How do you recharge? What do you do?
Whenever I can, I swim. I like swimming. It's like a moving therapy. Because it's just like in a mantra, counting how many meters you're swimming. And you have the water, so it feels like you're in your mom's belly again. So I think everything moves you to relax and to rethink things. So for me, it's the best way to recharge. And I also love to go to the beach.
Yeah.
I have a solar battery inside myself. Mm-hmm. I need sun to recharge again. So mm-hmm. a mix of swimming and sun, I think that's perfect.
This venue is all about digital, right? What do you love about this industry? And maybe what do you hate about this industry?
I think the word digital at the same time, and love and hate it. Because it's a word that's going to die.
Yeah.
There's no point in, from, I don't know, 3-5 years from now, calling something digital.
Yeah.
It's just like there's no point in calling something electronic now.
Yeah.
Because it had a function many years ago to divide things that were plugged to electricity and things that were not. Uh-huh. The same is happening with digital right now. Uh-huh. So from some years from now, everything's going to be digital. So there's no point in saying this is digital, this is not. So that's why at the same time, I love this word because I made all my career based on that. But at the same time, I hate this because I have to get rid of this word.
Yeah.
Because it's not going to be useful 5 years from now. So I think that's my point of view on digital.
Is there a buzzword in this industry which you would delete from the planet? Because it's just killing you.
Many of them, especially some of them in Portuguese. Let me take one. Because there are some. Adapt. Because every time you create something for a media and you have to adapt
to
digital, it's wrong.
Yeah.
Whenever you need to adapt to something, it was not meant to be on that media. So it was born wrong.
Yeah.
So we don't need to adapt things anymore. We need to think throughout all the medias. And the ideas that must survive are ideas that don't need to be adapted to anything. They are just made for all the mediums.
Yeah.
So adaptation, for me, is a terrible word.
So closing question would be like an outlook in the near future. Do you think creative work will change? And if so, how will it change? Or what has to change?
I think creative work will change the world. It's changing already. I think more and more with the machines coming over, what will differentiate us from them is the creative power. Mm-hmm. Because we know how to come out with ideas that they were not meant to be created.
Yeah.
Let me try to explain this. I believe humans in the future will be paid to make mistakes. Because machines, they don't make mistakes. But we need mistakes. Mm-hmm. Picasso did a lot of mistakes before coming to the cubism. Without mistakes, he wouldn't be Picasso. So I think that's the way we have to differentiate ourselves from the machines, because they will do things that you cannot have mistakes, like driving a car. You can do a mistake when driving a car. Let the machines do this.
Yeah.
Let's be at the back seat thinking of ways of doing mistakes, doing coming out with new ideas from nowhere. We have no explanation. It's pure inspiration. So that's why I think creativity will, in a way, save the world. Otherwise, everything will be so correct, and it will be a boring planet.
Boring and efficient.
So it's up to us to make a world, a planet that's not boring.
Talking to you was not boring. Listening to you was not boring. I hope you don't have a boring day today and not tomorrow. I'm sure about that. Thanks for coming by.
Thank you so much.
Have fun. And that was the last one for today. We'll see you guys tomorrow at the Mexico 2018.
Cool.
Thanks. That was really fun.